Cook and Cash Recycle TV, the Association of Mechanics in my bar. With the O2 here. You can get changed while you're in
no,
there.
No, I would do. Yeah, I don't mind.
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. First of all, how's the shoulder?
Shoulder is okay. You know, I strained it in sparring in Detroit, but you know these things happen. When you're a big guy and you're boxing 12 rounds 4 days a week, and you're getting pushed very hard, then and the thing is, I never worked out like this before, so now he's trying to take me to the next level. So my shoulder's working triple time hot, you know. So it's breaking down. It's gonna build back up stronger. So that's the aim of you know. But it's all good, though.
Obviously, people were asking. You was asked. No question marks over December the 12th. You'll be there, one arm, one leg. You said.
Yeah, listen. I try my best not to pull up from fights. I try and show up. You know what I mean? I don't like letting the fans down because the fans pay good money, and you know the fans been supporting me through the good and the bad times. So I try and give the fans what I feel they deserve. You know, and that's for me to show up and knock somebody out, injured or not. And if it's a bad injury that I can't avoid, then you know, I never say anything to anybody that's gotten with it.
Obviously, listening to your Sky interview there, Dylan, you seem like obviously not the most ideal way you'd want to win that fight, but you got the job done in the end and got Minto out of there.
Yeah, you know, if you can see, I went right hand happy because my shoulder was bad. When was the last time you ever seen me throwing so much right hand in the first round of a fight? Never. But you know, some you know stuff happened, man. You know.
But you had the first round knockdown, and obviously that was right at the end of the first round, but he managed to come back from that. But he was taking wild swings at you, wasn't he? Obviously,
he
came there to have a fight.
Brad Minto is tough in his game. He was never going to show up to lie down. He's a strong guy, and I have a lot of respect for him. You know, he took this fight on short notice, and he showed up to fight. You know, he carries a little bit of power, but, man, whatever, man.
But listen, like I said, now you can focus fully on December the 12th. You've got this out of the way. Joshua's got a job to do tonight, and then December 12th, it's going to be on.
Yeah. It's going to be a massive fight for Britain, and one I'm looking forward to. One I can't wait for, you know. And trust me, I'll show up for that fight.
There's a little altercation after the weigh-in yesterday. What sparked that off?
Anthony and his boys stepped up and started. I was on the photo shoot. It's my set. My time to take photo. Him and his boys bombard the photo shoot. I started giving it, so I stepped up to them, that's all. You know, nothing special.
But obviously, without you being held back, it looked like you were obviously walking towards one another.
Listen, he offered me that and he said, let's go then, so I went. I'm not going to, you know what I mean, I'm not no punk, so, you know. It is what it is, man. If he wants to go, then we can go, you know. He's lucky that I got held back because I would have teed off.
You're going now, obviously, to ringside to watch his fight against Cornish.
Yeah, I know they got coming up fight already anyway, you know. Maybe a good fight and he's not kind of shouting around like I say, you know what I mean, you know. So we'll see. Hopefully Gary Cornish can do something to repel him for a round, but I can't see it. Gary Cornish have no power. Listen, like I said, you know, I'm not really gonna try and badmouth him too much, but it's facts, you know what I mean? Am I lying? Can you see Gary Cornish going two rounds against Anthony Joshua? Answer that question and be honest.
Well, in about half hour, we'll find out.
No, don't be biased. Stop sitting on the fence. Answer the question.
It's not my job to do that.
Don't sit on the fence. It's
I
a fight.
Sit on the fence.
You said to me I was going to knock Costa out in Iran. So why are you sitting on the fence now?
Listen, but that was a private conversation I had with you. That's
yeah, but I'm
difference.
Asking you a question.
Well, listen, I have
you're
to see
a boxing
I have
fan.
To be
what do you think
it's
he's
like,
going to go?
It's like you asking me whether Joshua will beat you. I'm not going to answer that. Yeah.
You can. Do you think Joshua's going to beat me?
That's it. I don't need to answer
it's
that.
It's a free world.
I don't need to answer that because I'm asking you the question. Like,
listen, man.
It's irrelevant.
Listen, your response says it all.
What does?
If I had a camera, I'd video the look on your face now and show it to the people. Listen, it'd be a good fight. I just hope Gary Cornish can do whatever he can do, man. It doesn't matter, you know, whatever. But
you're allowed to have your opinion, like, same with anyone else, so.
Yeah, you know, Minto's always going to be one of them kind of opponents, the small guy, move around, tries to, you know, whatever.
All right, well, listen, Dylan, I won't take too much of your time. Thank you very much.
This belt gives you a top 10 ranking, doesn't it?
The WBC International Set, yes, it will do.
Coming back over 2 year suspension and being ranked up 10 in 10 months after a 2 year layoff.
You're not doing too badly.
Yeah, you know, I can't complain. I can't complain about nothing, you know.
Right,
my kids will be proud of this when I take it home and show him tomorrow.
Alright, cool. Listen,
thanks anyway, man.
Thanks to all to Eiffel TV all the way during this week. And like I said,
listen, whenever you're ready, just phone me, innit?
Yeah?
I call the phone, innit? I pick up, innit?
You don't answer the phone to me.
I answer the phone, innit?
No.
You come say me, innit?
My phone is on payphone. So you don't know it's my number. Dylan, thanks to all to Eiffel TV.
I love, man.
Alright, cool. Respect. Coon Cassis, Dylan White, Eiffel TV.
Thanks,
thank
buddy.
You very much.